Hello, welcome back to another episode of SDS. Today we are back on the podcast. I've missed it. Obviously, we've been doing the podcast still regularly. I'm saying I missed it like we've been away for a while. We haven't. We're still keeping up with weekly podcasts, which is impressive to do in preseason, which is amazing. But because we're used to doing two a week during the season, maybe three sometimes during the season, doing one podcast a week kind of feels like the gap feels long. But we're here today to do a podcast. As you can see by the title, we are doing our top 10 again, okay? Top 10 are so fun. I'll explain to you how it works. The category today is top 10 players in the Premier League in the last decade. But before I explain how this is going to work, let me introduce the table. Next to me, my trusty boy. Trusty boy? I was going to call you a sidekick. I was my trusty sidekick. I was like, no, sidekick sounds like I'm violating you. But yeah. I was like, you know, he's the OG. Robin. No, but this is, you know,
it's called Robin, you know.
Huh? I don't mind Robin.
Let's call you Robin.
I thought he was calling me Moist.
No, never. Never. Star player, hey!
Welcome. I lost to the winner. Huh? I lost to the winner.
He lost our mastermind.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Speaking of losing to the winner, and speaking of the winner, he's here with his brand new trophy. Isn't he?
Didn't notice you guys there.
Hey.
You
want to feel it?
You look a bit different. Yeah, it's heavy, isn't it?
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah.
Nah, I'm not gonna lie
Stars,
to you.
You wanna
I would have felt if Faisal won.
Faisal is in the background.
Today we've got some people in the background. Faisal and Fuad are here today in the background. But Lias came with his trophy.
You know how weird you gotta be to bring your trophy from where he's living to come here.
Oh come on, it's here.
You think my boy Faisal would do that?
He's been carrying it all day, by the way.
Yeah, he's carrying it all day, bro.
Takes it everywhere.
Restaurant as well.
Takes it everywhere.
Even took pictures with the waiters and that.
You need that picture
of like Messi in the bed or Mane did it in the bed.
Honestly, I'm recreating that shit. You gave me more ideas, didn't it?
And last but certainly not least, it's Lima.
It feels good to be back, man. It feels good to be back.
On the rhythm.
Yes. It's good to have you. I will be explaining the top 10. But before I do, I just want to say, we're doing a live show. You guys probably know by now. Our first ever live show will be next week on the 26th of July. At the time of filming, the tickets went out today. And
how
we sold out in 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
Wow. So let's give a round of applause.
Oh, crazy, man.
If you want extra tickets, shout star player. I know he's got extra tickets.
We sold out in 2 minutes, which means the interest is obviously there. It isn't a big venue, but it's just amazing to see that we could sell out that far, especially our first live show. So for sure, all that needs to happen now is we need to have a good live show. So if you guys are going to be there, from the ones that are watching, hopefully you guys will enjoy it. If it goes really well, seeing the demand and the fact that hopefully we enjoy it, we're definitely going to do another one soon. Hopefully, coming to a city near you.
We might tour.
Well, you never know. Hey, if we start out quick, we might have to do maybe a British tour first, and then maybe world tour. You never know. But
if it's a world tour.
Hey, tour.
Hey,
where are we going first? Where are we going first?
Iraq.
Faisal said Iraq.
Get that brother out of here, man. Iraq? You couldn't even defend your country, bro.
What are you talking about? You couldn't even defend your country.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, jeez. All right, but let's get into this. Let's get into this video. We are doing the top 10. Like I said, top 10 players in the Premier League in the last decade. The way this works is I've got a bunch of people to send me their list, okay? So the people that were involved in sending their list was everyone on the table here. So myself, Stars, Lee Ban, and Lias.
I pray not
after. Along with Fuad, Fu-Izzy, Hasib, Ren, Faisal, Ilias, and Chunks.
Okay, no Alfie.
Alhamdulillah.
Not Alfie this time.
No Alfie this year. Wow.
The teen your hype, bro.
Not Alfie this time. So there's 10 people, all right? Yeah. And the way this works is we then put everyone's top 10 list onto this Excel spreadsheet. It's a bit nerdy, but it works out. And for example, if I have someone in 10th, they get 1 point. And if I have someone in first, they get 10 points. Mm. Second, they get 9. Third, they get, for example, and so on. Then all of our scores get accumulated and then the players that on the list get a final score out of 100 because there was 10 of us, right? So 10 is a perfect first place. And then we rank the players from the points they have, okay? At home, you guys, feel free to put in a list of your top 10 players in the last decade of the Premier League. Let us know this is any position. So players maybe who had the best, biggest impact in the last 10 years, players that you just think were the best players to for their period they played in the Premier League. It has to be from 2013 till now, so last 10 years. I can reveal that there was 20 different players on the list.
Wow. 20.
So we asked for a top 10, but 20 different names were mentioned.
I know Fuad's going to be quirky. Yeah. I know he is.
20 different names. So before we get to the top 10, I'm going to mention the guys that didn't make the top 10. And I will go through a little bit and we'll speak about who put them where and everything. And then eventually we'll get to our top 10. So stick around, get your popcorn, because these top 10 videos are super fun. So the first player, obviously it's not in 20th place, it's in 16th place because between, there's a lot of ties, joints, 11th, joints, 13th, whatever. So in 16th place, so right at the bottom, in last place, with 1 point, because one person had him in the list and he had him in that 10th. No one else had him in. So he just made someone's list and he made no one else's list. It is, si señor, Bobby Firmino.
Oh, wow.
Good player, good servant.
One person had Bobby Firmino.
Who do you guys think it is?
On their list.
Is it in this?
I think it is.
Yes, one person was in the list and they had him in 10th.
Let me guess.
Bobby Firmino obviously left Liverpool. Probably one person that wants them at their club now still.
Oh my, it's Fu. Of course, it's Fu, is he?
No, he's gone from Liverpool. No, who wants to sign Firmino?
Faisal, come on.
Faisal had him.
Bobby Firmino.
Yeah, he's got,
he thinks he's watching the podcast.
Yeah, literally.
the tenth best player in the last decade of Premier League history for Faisal is Bobby Firmino.
That's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous.
It's Bobby Firmino.
No disrespect.
Yeah. I mean, no one had him.
Of course not. Of course.
He should have made it in.
Nah, he's a good. Well, did you have him?
I didn't have him. That's right. He should have made it in.
Well, okay, where would it be for you? Top 20 at least.
Top 20, you could argue. Yeah.
23. Yeah. Top 20.
He didn't make my top 12. I'll tell you that right now.
Yeah.
So he's struggling. Yeah. Maybe.
Maybe top 20 is. Yeah.
Maybe.
I could see that. Maybe.
He's a great player, by the way.
Of course. Great servant.
It sounds like it's almost he's a scrub, but no, he's a great player. He was huge to Liverpool's success, but. We're talking about the last 10 years of evidence, bro.
Yeah. And how many strikers everyone's probably put in. You're not really thinking of. Thinking of goals more than anything.
He's a really good player.
Good player.
Top 10.
No, amazing player.
Impact player. Amazing as well.
Technical player.
He was, a lot of Liverpool players were saying, he was the most technically gifted player.
Yeah, definitely.
Even when he had Thiago Alcantara and stuff like that. He was the IQ.
The link up play.
Link up. The dummies, the back kills, the assists.
I remember I said that. I think we was together.
Everything. Someone didn't believe me.
What'd you say? Yes, I remember that.
I remember saying it. And then you messaged Trent.
I remember. I mean,
was it someone else?
I don't know, but I remember you mentioned it. Yeah. But even on...
And then Trent, you just asked Trent, who's the most technical? He went Firmino and Thiago.
Yeah.
Even Liverpool have done videos where the players will say, Firmino's most technically gifted.
Yeah. You could tell, so when you're watching him, you could just tell.
He gets the best out of his teammates as well.
I feel like he's one of them ones who does... he's one of them ones at training. He's mad.
Oh, he must be
crazy. Madness. But as a player in last decade, we respect his career.
Yeah, therefore.
He sacrificed a lot.
Top 10's crazy though.
I mean, top 10 to be fair, one person put him in the 10th. So even the guy who put him in top 10 just had him just make it.
I was going to say, if Fuizzi doesn't have a Liverpool or like ex-Liverpool player in there.
You couldn't do it 10 years before that.
Yeah. But let's move forward now. In 15th place, second last, with only 2 points, because two people had him in that 10th. No one else had him in the list.
Okay.
Only 2 points out of 100. Vincent Kompany. I think that's a solid shout. He made it to my shortlist.
Let me ask you guys, when did he join? It was like 2009.
He joined, I think 2008, 2009. I think that's when he joined.
But he stayed.
I know, but remember, he was in 18, 19. Like in and out kind of thing. Like I felt bad for him.
2019, right?
Yeah, he was comfortably in the last decade.
I know, but for me, it's just injuries and like he'll play here and there. I know he's played a lot of games, but
I find Kompany a really weird one, to be honest with you, because when I watched Kompany, I always thought at the time I was watching one of the best center backs in the world, not even just in the league, but the way like his rep has kind of aged. I see a lot of people on like social media say like, oh, he's maybe overrated, like he's not as good, like even in the same conversation as Rio. I always thought he was top class.
He's always, and I always said,
as a City player, being a United fan, he's like the one City player that I always thought, like, you know what? I actually like him.
Good character
about him. Good. But top 10 again, bro, we're talking about all-timers, bro. And Kompany, you could argue, is like an all-time great center back in the Prem, but there's big names ahead of him here.
Yeah.
And it's, for me as well, when it comes to top 10s, it's very hard to put in keepers, defenders, because there's so many good attackers. And so you got to be special to be mentioned in the top 10.
The forwards get rewarded and everyone forgets about the defensive players. True.
Unless you're...
The thing with Kompany, though, I'll say this.
It shouldn't be that way.
Yes, yeah, it shouldn't. You're right.
But when you look at the awards, the Ballon d'Ors and all of that.
And who gets paid the most? The forwards, the strikers.
He has so many big moments, though, for City in the last decade. So many winning goals.
Leicester goal, right?
Leicester goal. I mean,
Man United.
The header in tonight, I guess it doesn't really count because it's 11-12, right? And if it had been the last decade, it just misses out. But I think he even scored on the last day against West Ham when they won the league 1 year.
Leicester was it? The Leicester.
No, Leicester is like 18, 19. Yeah, yeah. I'm 18, saying 19. Even when they won,
obviously
the
goals
like
as a defender doesn't, it's not a good measuring stick, but AC just providing those moments.
But even the presence,
that's just like being a clutch player as a defender. Sergio Ramos has that gene. Company has that. He's done it. Koscielny, I was gonna say, has that. Like, these are defenders that I thought you guys were gonna laugh at Koscielny, by the way.
Koscielny
got us top four twice. Again, West Brom, I think, and against Hull City, our first FA Cup.
I thought they were gonna laugh.
I was waiting for the laugh. Koscielny
was.
I said, I knew.
I was happy with it. He scored against Hull in FA Cup final. He's gonna tell us, by the way, number 14, we got
Koscielny 2 points. Would definitely love to put him in. He's our favourite.
Nah, I mean, Cazola, I was thinking about it, but I was like, I can't do that.
Yeah. My favorite moment with Koscielny is the slap on the head, though.
Good thing that was in the last decade. Quaresma had him in a headlock in the Euros, bro. Good thing that was in the last decade, so we'll have to talk about that. Let's move up now.
In joint 14th place. And
who had company, by the way, in their list?
Oh, yes. Good question. Fuizi had him at 10th, and so did Chunks. They both had him in at 10th.
I don't think.
So it's company, good company.
Hey, that's good. Not that old, man.
All right, but let's move up now. The next player on our list.
You know, before you do, Sharks, I feel like no one's going to mention my United player.
United haven't been good in the last decade, so it's going to be interesting.
We haven't been good, so.
It's going to be interesting. Joint 14th now. They both have 3 points, right? One of them, I'll name the first one because he has 3 points because three people put him in 10th.
Okay.
The next person has 3 points because two people had him in, but one had him 9th, one had him 10th. So this one, three people had him in, but they all had him in last place, is Jamie Vardy.
Good. I consider him. He was in my shortlist.
Yeah, I consider
him in my shortlist.
Jamie Vardy. Jamie Vardy, he wasn't in your shortlist. He was in your top 10.
Was he in my shortlist?
Yeah.
Wow. Unless I did it wrong,
I'm just going off his thing here.
Well done.
Unless he put him wrong. So it is wrong. So it's not your top 10.
It's not my top 10.
All right. I mean, it says Vardy, star player here. I had him at 10.
You got one job, boy.
So did Ren. I had him at 10th, so did Ren. So he's got 2 points. He's got 2 points.
Then. Said, don't keep me in with that stinky company.
That's what he looked at me. I said,
the information's here in front of me. I'm just going what I've got. But yes, Jamie Vardy, I got him in. Ren has him in as well. Both of them at 10th. Mm. I mean, listen.
What a career.
Nothing wrong with that career, man.
His career, his whole entire Premier League career was from like the last 10 years. From like from the last 8 years.
That's a real gunman.
And what he's done, obviously he's won the leagues, won the FA Cup. On top of that, he stayed at Leicester. Couple top golden boots as well. Got a golden
goals.
Boot. Already got over. He's already in the 100 club in the short time he's been in the Prem.
Yeah, that record of consecutive games
was it 11?
Yeah. Venice through.
Exactly. Yep. It's 11 like 12 or something. Wow,
Vardy was like a meteorite, man. Honestly, like he just came, he landed, and bro, crazy.
Like it gives me hope. Came to the Premier League at 27.
You can still make it.
You can still make it. You got this year.
Came to Premier League 27. Still got over 100 goals. Yeah.
You got this year to make it.
You got half a year.
Yeah, half a year to make it. Get your preseason on now.
I've got. Listen,
get ready now.
I want to start
the Red Bulls, apparently.
I want new kick-ups in the corner of Arsenal
start
playing.
Impressing them.
Mikel. I know one of the coaches at Arsenal as well. You know, Tekka's Guru, who used to work like hashtag. He works at Arsenal.
Oh, yes, he does.
Issa. Yeah, look at this. But Vardy gives people hope, man.
Would you imagine they say, jump in the session.
I'm going to get killed though. You got. And the Rondo, I'm chasing.
That's crazy.
I'm getting killed. I just want one appearance, man.
One piece of the game.
Cup, why not? Bring me on.
Why not?
They'll go
why
viral.
Why can't I be the MVP?
They'll go viral.
MLS why not? Stars, why not?
Why not?
Why not?
Clubs need to realize.
It'll be good. You'll bring a more
profit. Good for exposure.
Yeah,
why not?
SS will bring a lot of exposure to us.
There you go. Hey, we'll do our post-match analysis after, bro. Dusty touch from Sharky, 22 minutes in.
Live watch along. I'm getting cooked. Shout out Vardy, man. Shout out Vardy. So Vardy, okay, so good stars didn't have him. Vardy joins... company.
Yeah, right.
Okay, well, hopefully this was right. The person who's in 14th place then is Alisson.
Goalkeeper's hype, bro. I'm not ever putting a goalkeeper in.
Alisson.
Oh, don't tell
Fuad,
me.
It's Fuad had him in at 10th.
It's Fuad.
And Renity had him at 9th.
I'm different, man. I'm different. Fuad just wants goalkeepers and defenders in this list, bro.
Hey, put some respect on the keeper.
He just wants representation,
bro. Yeah, you want representation. I clocked it, man. Yeah. Listen, hey. full back. The defense is.
What were you thinking about that? What were you thinking about that?
I mean, he's great. Of course, this is best keeper in the Premier League, what?
In the last decade? It
could be the world at times. Potentially, well, honestly.
Potentially, why not?
Could have been in the world.
It's probably him or De Gea.
Yeah.
Him or De Gea in the last decade.
De Gea, yeah. De Gea.
I would say Alisson was probably cleared him.
If someone ever put De Gea on their list.
No, I wouldn't.
Top 10 players.
I mean, in terms of keepers, though.
Top 10 keepers last decade. He's like top 2.
Yeah, that's definitely top 2.
Me, I would put Alisson.
I'd put fifth anyway, but.
Alisson, yeah. I think the question should be all-time goalkeepers in the Prem, where does he rank? Because I think he ranks very highly for that. Mm-hmm. He's so complete. And I always say goalkeeper is the one position for me that like is constantly improving. So I would say the best goalkeepers right now can probably do a lot more than the older ones could.
Yeah, facts.
So of what the game requires. Goalkeeper is definitely in that position.
Yeah.
And he has little to no flaws whatsoever in his game.
Yeah. I think he's the perfect goalkeeper.
For sure.
Yeah.
He's the perfect goalkeeper. Like, if I was to build a goalkeeper...
He's the least flawed. I would say that's the
prototype.
Yeah. He has no flaws. He's
got big mistakes in his game. We've seen loads of times, but who doesn't at this point?
Yeah, of course.
And it's all about big moments. Let's go winning goal to get you top four, get Champions League football.
How many teams can say they did that? In the 90th minute as well.
And it wasn't a shit goal. It was a goal a striker would be proud of.
They needed that to make top four.
Yeah. It's just unfortunate it was lockdown football.
Yeah.
Where did Fouad have him?
10th. Fouad had him at 10th and Rennie had him at 9th. So he got 3 points.
Renadine's goalkeeper is right.
3 points, man.
Melly is going to be on the list.
No space for goalkeepers.
Thanks, bro. No disrespect.
I'll tell you that for a fact. We're getting close to the top 10.
Yeah.
Mm. We're now at 13th, but then we still got loads of players to name because there's two people in 12th and three in 11th. So we've still got another 5 after this, but we'll go through them. In 13th place, and with 4 points, because 2 people had him in at 9th, no one else had him in, is Riyad Mahrez.
Oh, that's a bad one.
Riyad Mahrez.
Hey, shout my boy, I see the tape, man.
It was on my shortlist, but
that's a bad one, guys.
No,
that's a bad one, man. He's in my list.
I mean, these two are the ones I have him in.
That's on my list. Yeah. Riyad Mahrez.
I'll be real, yeah. There's two reasons for me. Obviously, too many quality players.
That's bad.
And also him being Algerian.
Like, what?
That is crazy.
Don't make enemies with the Algerians.
That's mental.
I'm Syrian if he was in the Prem.
What is he?
I'm just not putting Riyad Mahrez.
So if he was Syrian, you put him in?
Huh? Syrian.
It's because I beat you, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right.
Libyan, anything.
Put that trophy down, man. Guess what?
He's not on this list, bro.
That's nonsense.
I'm
joking. He's a quality player, though.
Why? Tell us why you guys had him in. And why you're contesting Algeria?
Okay,
why
obviously outside of the bias, right? Yeah. Take even the bias aside. You look at what Mahrez has done since I would say 2015-16, when his breakout year, PFA Player of the Year. What, 4 Premier League titles? Huge moments. Mm. I think he has the most assists in the league since he stepped into the league. Like since he stepped in, no one has had more assists in the Prem than him, bro.
Oh wow.
I don't know what we're not going to bring in the AFCON because like it's just a Premier League conversation.
100%. But
I'm very interested to see who you guys have more because in terms of body of work, this guy you can bring up.
Don't let me distract you.
I would love to see a body of work of the top 10 guys that ten players that have a better body of work in the last decade than Riyad Mahrez.
I think that's crazy harsh.
He sold it pretty well, to be fair.
Yeah, and bear in mind, it's not just the Man City, obviously. It's the best player on the biggest fairy tale moment
in history, bro.
I feel like that one there. Like for me, I didn't have him high in my top 10. I had him at 9th.
You both had him at 9th.
First. Okay.
Yeah. So you'd say he was the best player in that Leicester team.
The award shows he was the best player. He won PFA Player of the Year, bro.
Obviously, Vardy was the gunman, but in terms of...
Kante, if you want to argue Kante. But that season, Mahrez was the guy. Mahrez was the one that they went to, especially, people forget, that period in the season where they went to Watford, when they went to Newcastle, when they went to the Etihad. He was the... Okay, don't do that. These guys gassing up the Emirates when they came second in the league, bro. But Mahrez was the go-to guy at the end of the season.
They didn't beat us, so it's calm.
That's fine.
But for me, that's harsh, I'm interested to see you guys got top 10, but that's a harsh one for me.
No one voted for Mixer Frost, too.
Yeah, that's crazy. To me, that's wild. That is wild. That's disrespectful.
How comes?
Damn, man. What you guys got against Muslims, man?
Okay, that's how we move up. What could I have, bro? That's my brother.
Yeah, I'm not gonna lie to you. I love the storytelling about Elias.
Nah, it was good, man. It's so
he ain't on his list, man. He ain't on his list.
I don't know why. I feel like Mahrez is a slightly different.
A lot of people have said that. Well, not a lot, but I know one person who said it to me. It's like, You know, like at Man City, he was never really like the guy. Like he was a role player. He was like a role player kind of thing. I'm telling you, someone told me that.
Say that name.
I'm gonna tell you.
Does it rhyme with Hazel?
Sometimes.
Does it rhyme with Hazel?
Sometimes he dips his hair into something to change the color of it. That's about it.
Oh my God, this guy right here. This 40-year-old who still dyes his hair, bro. This guy's crazy, man. Get a three inside.
Keep it under control. The viewers can't see them, so we can't see them. Remember, viewers can't see us, we can't see them.
That's crazy.
All right, let's move on.
No, you're not actually shocked. Now I'm happy he's not on the list.
Why?
Now I'm happy he's not on the top 10.
Why?
Because the way these two got angry at it.
Oh, yeah.
That's nonsense, bro. Has
anyone replaced me in the top 10?
Huh?
Oh, you did.
Bro,
Jamie Vardy, never
from
mind.
From 1 through to 8th, that's my top 8, exactly, in order, 1 to 8.
Yeah, bro, that's my one player that I don't think I'll have in my top
8. So you'll see. Yeah. My 1 to 8. All right, let's move up now. We've got next player. It's got 8 points, so jumping up a little bit.
Okay.
In 12th place, well, we've got two players, obviously, in joint 12th. Both of them are 8 points.
One of them's gonna be
the first one is in 12th place because he has 8 points, but from one person.
That means he's
someone
high.
Had him in at third.
It has to be Rennedy.
This is silly. This is a silly one. I already know. And it's only one suspect, I can tell.
This player.
He's Congolese, West African.
Yeah, 100%. Place.
He's got the crazy waist.
No, I think they're Central African.
Central African?
Yeah.
Central.
This person is Steven Gerrard.
Good one. Who's got that joke? That's a good joke. The brother that retired in like 2016. Good one. When I was still in uni. The guy that retired when I was still in uni, yeah?
Bro,
That's the guy.
He left the Premier League. Year he left the Premier League.
What year he left?
Bro, 2015.
Wow.
Wait.
So when I was, how old would it be? So when I was 20. When I was 20. You know how old I am now? 28.
Damn, man.
Damn.
Yeah, you're getting up there.
And he's putting him in there. Good one. That's a good joke.
That's crazy.
I swear.
If it right, does it rhyme with monks?
Huh?
Who is it? Is it a guy with the crazy waist?
Best seasons, yeah. That's crazy.
What?
Guy with the Congolese waist?
No.
Is it Fruzy?
Oh my God. You know,
he's the new
this guy. Why is his life 24/7? It's a skit. Everything's a skit for this guy, you know?
He's a walking skit. He did everything. Everything is a prank. Everything's a joke.
He wrote this list, writing Gerrard. He's like, they gonna love this one, bro. I can just imagine the reactions. He's like the Riddler, bro.
Yeah, literally, I'm telling you.
He's not even here. And he's
laughing his ass off.
I know he gave Hasib the list like 10 minutes after he got given. 10 minutes.
Cooking it.
Has to be
20. Nah, he's trolling. He's trolling.
We might start banning him from this.
Yeah, but then
he definitely got Lucas Leiva in 7th.
Something like that. Probably put Fernando Torres.
Joint with him in 12th place. Joint 12th place. We've also got 8 points, but he's only got it through two people. Because they both had him in at 7th, so 4 and 4. Is Gundogan.
What?
Yeah, he just...
Oh my God. Nah, stay on that side over there, brother. We want to hear about you.
Gundogan, yeah.
That is unfortunate.
Ivan, as you can see by his reaction, is the one that has been, and Faisal's the
one. Oh my
God.
Yeah.
I said it again, that was on my shortlist.
Wow.
Just didn't make it.
You know, we know we're talking about a top
yeah,
midfielder.
Top 10 is going to be good, bro.
Bearman, this is top 10 the last 10 years.
Yes. How many midfielders can you name off the top of your head that's had a decade in Premier League?
It's not midfielders, it's all positions.
Okay. All right, even so.
Off the bat, I can think of three that I have in my list for sure.
And that's just midfielders.
Yeah, it does exactly. Just
imagine Bell.
Yeah. And now imagine all positions. That are in my list.
Yeah, who's it? Bruno Fernandes.
Huh? You're talking about impact. Huh? You're talking about, let's say, impact, clutch.
Yeah. I know that. I think
leader. How many big moments has he had?
He's top.
There was one season where the guy played striker.
Mm-hmm.
I'm started banging goals. You put him DM, he's killing it. You put him a box to box, he's killing it. Cam, he's killing it. How many midfielders do you know in the last decade that's literally multifunctional, technical, gets goals, creates chances? How many midfielders do you know that can do everything?
It
wasn't
easy. Bear in mind,
they
didn't have a striker and they put this guy up top and he was bagging.
Yeah. Nah, Gundogan is an all-time Premier League legend, bro, for sure.
Mental.
I considered him very, very highly.
Yeah.
But... again, bro, there's players.
Two players he's been rallying for so much today, and he's been gutted about two City players, Mahrez and Gundogan.
Because if we're doing the last decade, but let's be honest though, last decade,
man,
like who's dominating? They've been the best team in the last decade, so they're gonna have
100%.
Bro, I'll tell you right now, like a little spoiler, I don't have a single Man United player on my list.
Yeah, I mean,
to be fair, I'll be surprised.
I can't have a Man United player.
I don't think there's one.
Man City,
Liverpool,
Chelsea,
Pogba.
You know where I put Arsenal?
Yeah.
I don't know. Gundogan for me, I feel like he deserves to be on the list. Like,
just like Riyad Mahrez,
at least on the list. At least on the list for me.
I can't. Damn, I'm not against it. I think he's a great player. I think he could have definitely made the list.
But yeah, definitely.
He just missed out.
Yeah. Yeah. Like you said, all the players that missed out have a chance, isn't it? But
it's tough.
I'm just intrigued now to see who actually made the.
I mean, we're getting close to the top 10. We're getting close. We haven't even got to the top 10 yet.
That's crazy.
We haven't even got to the top 10 yet.
Yeah.
And so many of the players have missed out.
Yeah.
So let's find out who's next. Okay. All right. So next, we are into 11th place, but it's three players in all joint 11th place. Mm-hmm. After this, we'll get into the top 10. So the first player is in 11th place. One person had him in, and he's got 9 points.
Oh, here we go again.
Someone's got him in second.
Can we guess? Can we all have a choice?
Yeah,
I guess. Go,
leave it. Liverpool player facts.
Yeah.
What player? Is it Trent or something like that?
Wait, is it a Liverpool player?
No, don't even reveal it. I don't even know.
Okay, I know it's a Liverpool. I know for a fact it's a Liverpool player.
Just guess.
And I know who the culprit is.
Just guess. And this person has him in second, so he's got 9 points.
Oh, I know who it is.
I feel like, shall I take
it? It's, I know who it is.
I think it's Luis Suarez. Luis Suarez second.
Name Rise the Monks?
No, it's Fruzy. What's wrong with Fruzy?
I'm on to him. I don't know why.
How are you on to him?
Ever since you mentioned who was it in the previous...
Palliser.
No, in the thing.
Top 10. Proves top 10.
No, just now. In this list. Who did you mention before?
Gerard.
A company. So I'm starting to think like he might be mentioning people from like...
You got to remember who else mentioned company.
Yeah, Foo.
Exactly, and who else did he put? Gerard, Suarez.
I was gonna say it's one of them two.
Me, Luis's got Suarez in second.
I should have given Mahrez 10 points, bro. I should have put Mahrez first and said, "Screw all you guys."
Yeah. Who put Suarez top 10?
Delusional.
Gerard third. So obviously, you know what he's trying to do.
Yeah, see, he's.
Well, might have to ban him after this.
Yeah, you have to ban him.
Is Henderson in this list?
He's ruining the list.
No, goodbye now.
He's ruining the list.
We have to ban him.
I know he's probably got first.
So he's doing it what 1 year and a half? Obviously the. Work he did, like the football he played, whatever. What was it, year and a half?
Yeah, but
the he's probably had the best season out of anyone in the last.
You know, I'm not gonna lie to you.
Haaland's still got something to say about.
Yeah, Haaland's got something.
Salah's got something to say about that.
Nah, I still think Suarez had a better season than Haaland.
Suarez, Drogba was really good that 1 year too.
Yeah.
There's a lot of players that are top.
No, but in the last decade.
Oh, last decade.
Yeah, Suarez for sure.
2013-14.
Suarez was Salah.
He missed like 8 games. For me, first 8 games.
I think.
Yeah, but you're looking at more the fun side. You enjoyed it more.
Yeah, I enjoyed it more. Yeah.
Why enjoy? So you're enjoying Liverpool, yeah?
I enjoy football though.
Liverpool are biggest rivals.
I enjoy football though.
Salah's his favorite winger in Premier League.
Can't enjoy Liverpool though, surely.
No, but Suarez.
Bro, he rides up
the Bro, that's a generational.
That's what I'm saying.
That's like a one.
But today is all of his
right now for Liverpool Man City.
So what do you want me to do? Put Bruno and Pogba and Lukaku in this list. What do you want me to do, Ake?
Hey, Lukaku, the last 10 years.
Be serious, man. What do you want me to do in this list?
Hey, man.
What the work he did for Everton, Man United.
Ake, I'm starving. My team's starving, Ake. We're starving, Ake. What do you want me to do, Ake?
You can have that.
Even talking about eating.
Let's move on.
They're eating, bro. They're eating. Eating what?
As in, they got up. At least they probably have.
They're eating a big place.
Or a trophy, man. Or a trophy.
Next player. The next player. This player has same amount of points. He's in 11th place.
Yeah.
It's getting worrisome. I've not one of my players been said.
He's in 11th place. Three people had him in. One has him in at 6th, which is the highest. And 2 has him in at 9th. And no one's had him in. It's Virgil van Dijk.
Ni hao.
Yeah, this last 10 years.
Shanghai.
So, Lias had him in 6th. He's had him high.
Got it. Lias had him 6.
I'm the Liverpool hater, by the way. Wow. Change the agenda.
And then Fu Izzy, who's the Liverpool fan, had him at 9th. And Hasib had him at 9th. But no one else had him in top 10.
Look, man. I'm the first person to come out and say defenders, hype, mm-hmm. goalkeepers. I'm not buying it, mm-hmm. but... In terms of impact on their team, Virgil van Dijk has probably had as much of an impact in his team's success mm-hmm. as almost every single player on this list. I can't think of many center backs I've seen come to a club and completely change their defensive outlook in like months, let alone seasons. Mm. So you want a player of the season, for God's sake. For me, this is harsh. I think there's more to it than analysis here, bro. I think van Dijk should be here, bro. That's crazy.
No, van Dijk, to be fair, van Dijk... Yeah, I probably should have put him in. I'm not going to lie.
Bro, that's
he's on a short
crazy.
List. That's me. He's on a short list.
That's my reasoning.
I'm shocked, honestly.
That's my reasoning.
Mahrez, to be honest, I expected Mahrez. Van Dijk? Wow. Fair enough, bro.
No, Van Dijk doesn't deserve more respect, man.
For me personally, for this top 10, I didn't want to put defenders. That's one of the reasons.
Okay, but I did say it's any position.
Yeah, but I didn't want to
put defenders. Could be anyone. Goalkeepers, defenders, everyone.
You know what is as well, yeah? Obviously, when we do our top 10s, more time, you're like, realistically, Van Dijk should have made it maybe. But no one's going to do that.
Also, I just want to make a point though on the Van Dijk thing. For me, it's 3 years.
Yeah, that's how I look at it. I looked at longevity and body
work. I'm going to keep you to that because if I see a player who's been in the Premier League for less than 3 years in your top 10,
check it. I'm going to keep you to that. It's consistent. Mine is consistent. So his stint was 3 years. Literally.
I hear it.
Yeah, the impact, I'm not going to lie to you, he had a huge impact for Liverpool.
Massive
impact. And obviously, you can say he's probably one of the reasons why they ended up having the success that
they did. But second also, in Ballon d'Or.
But Messi, bro.
You saw the impact that he had.
No, three years.
And then there's other people on the list that I just feel like they've had that more longevity.
Like John Stones.
Yeah, so for me, I don't know. I'm sticking.
John Stones is in this list for Van Dijk.
We'll find out.
Whatever I say,
that just goes on to it.
Go on.
Ni hao. You think he should go to China?
Saudi now, bro.
Saudi, yes. Al Ahli.
It's Saudi now.
Yes.
I know the people are eagerly waiting to hear the top 10, so please just keep this going. There's one more player that's outside the top 10 who's joint with Van Dijk and Suarez, and that is Kyle Walker.
Oh. Who put Kyle Walker this high, bro?
Quite a few people.
That's you ridiculous.
Guys say, Doc is cool, guys.
Stars be one of them.
He's on my list.
He's got him in the 8th, which is the highest.
You know how you talk about body of work?
Don't look at me when you say that.
This guy. Tottenham, Man City, he's still hard now.
Do you want to know who
you're crazy
that
is?
Do you want to know
who? Walker, not Morris.
Do you want to know?
Don't nod your head like that.
Do you want to know who you
are? You gassing up, hey?
Do you want to know who your company is?
Hey, representation, right?
Spurs and defense.
Do you want to know who your company is? Who else had Walker in?
Go on.
Fouad, obviously.
Real.
Because he's nodding his head. Hasib.
Facts.
And Renedy.
That's awful company. Elite. That's the worst company I can even think of.
Are you happy about company?
I am. Okay, good. I didn't hear Fouzi.
True.
You missed one of the three bozos, bro. You got the other two.
Why did I not put Kyle Walker in?
If you're talking about body work and what have they done to Premier League, in the Premier League.
Kyle Walker.
Nah, he's been class.
From Spurs to Man City.
Look, for me, clearly, when we get there, like I said to you, my first to eighth place is exactly the order of what the combined list finished, first to eighth. So I was on the right track. My ninth and tenth was one, I'm not going to say, my ninth hasn't been said. My tenth was Vardy because I like the story. So I had no space for Kyle Walker, unfortunately for Van Dijk, and I like Mahrez, and Gundogan.
I'll be real with you.
But I'm going to tell you something.
Kyle Walker didn't even make my shortlist.
Bro,
that's poor from you.
Didn't make my shortlist, bro.
That's poor from you. But someone told me.
Who are they? People are talking to me.
Someone said to me, he could be arguably Pep's best signing that season.
Absolutely nonsense, bro.
Ever.
He just signed a guy who scored 36 goals in a year, bro.
Ever.
What are we doing here?
You know how I said earlier? Don't voice your anger towards me. I got told by someone.
Someone is an idiot. How about that?
Guess who?
Someone's always telling
you something. Hold on. If I know them, I'm sorry. Idiot is a big word.
Did he die his tips as well?
Yeah.
The same guy that was dying since before.
Potentially stuff.
Oh no, he is an idiot though. What are we doing here?
Brad, yeah.
Are you being influenced?
Hold on, what happened to getting these guys to speak up about this stuff for yourself?
This guy's picks are being influenced by this guy.
Yeah.
Did I have Alisson on my
list?
Be a man.
Okay, we have these guys at our disposal. Fouad, can you come here and defend Kyle Walker, please?
Yes, come.
Come to one of the microphones. Take one of the microphones.
Take that, lose this one.
Yeah, yeah. Because you see, what we're talking about, Kyle Walker, is an all-timer right back. When you talk about 100%. The all-time Premier League right backs, Kyle Walker will be one of the names you talk about at right back.
Outside of Haaland,
who is the best signing Pep has made in his time? İlkay Gundogan, you can argue Kyle Walker's given just as much consistency, way more availability. The amount of times he's had to adapt his role from flying fullback, let's not forget this is a guy who couldn't defend, to now he's the cover centre-back. Now he's the right-sided of a back three. Bro, this guy has adapted his game to a team that's constantly winning, and he's been the main one consistent piece. All of them other pieces, they've switched around. De Bruyne is there as well, but defensively, who's the one piece that doesn't move? What do you mean? Fernandinho came and went.
It's not Pep signings, though.
Yeah. But okay.
But for me, all-timers, when you talk about it, Kyle Walker's there.
He's still doing it now.
A lot of things.
Everyone is fit, he doesn't even play anymore.
A lot of the times, players of his ability, when they're reliant on pace, they decline very quickly.
If there's one
thing we've seen with him, that shit ain't happening.
He's still one of the fastest.
He's still there.
He's still one of the fastest.
Even when they got a test like Vinny, who do they call?
Everything he said is true, and everything I agree with. And he deserves the praise. He definitely is one of the greatest right backs. But
we only have 10 spots.
We have 10 spots.
I'm saying the greatest.
There's so many attackers, so many midfielders. Come on, I don't have space for him. And that doesn't mean it doesn't take anything away from him.
I just
don't have space for Kyle Walker because I just think there's about 15 players.
Exactly. Is he the only right back in this list?
You know what I mean?
Yes.
He's the only defender I had. Like defender / goalkeeper.
Why are you doing that?
I'm surprised that a guy from Liverpool didn't make it.
Oh, you didn't put him in?
No, but I didn't put any right back in. Yeah. But I'm thinking if I was going to put one right back in, I probably wouldn't have put Kyle Walker.
You put Trent above Kyle Walker?
Yeah.
The last decade?
Yeah, I just think he's a better right back. He's not a better defender. He's a better player
offensive
than Kyle Walker. I'd rather have Trent than Kyle Walker.
Last 10 years, I don't know.
A better right back.
No, okay. If you notice, I changed. He's a better footballer than Kyle Walker. Okay. He's not a better in terms of what a right back has to do.
Yeah.
But let's find out who did make our list because we're finally here at our top 10.
Jeez.
The combined SDS top 10 Premier League players in the last decade starts now. In 10th place, made that spot. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 out of the 10 people had him in their list somewhere. It's Raheem Sterling.
Yep.
I forgot about him.
He deserves that.
I completely forgot about him.
He deserves that. I had him exactly where I put him.
You know, I think it would exactly be disrespectful if he wasn't on your list.
Exactly where I put him.
I think it would be
disrespectful if he wasn't on your list. Disrespectful, for what he's done.
So do you want to know who disrespected him then?
Please.
Fuad.
Wow.
Izzy.
Wow.
Hasib.
Wow.
Renedy.
Wow.
And Lias.
I don't know if I still would have him though, to be honest with you. I definitely forgot about him, but he would have been fighting for 10th.
I think if you're talking about last 10 years, since he came on the scene around 2013, right?
So his
this is literally his period. Like, if you really look at it. And I think in the last 10 years, goals.
Part of so many different teams, systems. And
if you look at by 26, bro, he's already 100 PR. He's in the 100 PR club.
Yeah.
He's had seasons where he's, correct me if I'm wrong, but like under Guardiola, I think he's the third highest scorer ever.
After
Aguero and Messi.
Yeah,
that's true.
He's had a season where he scored 32 goals. He was top scorer for Man City when they won the league in 2018.
Centurion season, how many points he saves them. Yeah. Clutch goals. Clutch
Golden
goals.
Boy.
Bournemouth goal, remember.
Southampton.
You know, Everton, Golden Boy. He's won the Golden Boy Award.
Yeah, Golden Boy, yeah.
Like, there's so much.
How many Prems?
4 Prems. And you could argue that he's been one of the most, in terms of as attackers during the Pep era, he's one of the most crucial.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Yeah, you could even argue that he's a system player and all of that. But at the end of the day, you still have to be effective. You still have to be efficient.
How many
you still
goals?
Have to be able to do,
he scored 100
do your job.
Plus goals. I don't care about the system.
No one else was scoring those goals in the same system.
I don't even believe in the whole system thing. I think that's a whole argument, another argument itself. But I don't think there's anything such as a... I think people get penalised for just being effective in a certain system.
When he first signed to City for 50 mil, how big of a deal
And people were criticising saying that there was going to be a flop.
Loftus, it's
crazy. Like, what he's achieved was mad. And he's only, 28 now?
28.
It's crazy.
I think already for me, it might be crazy. Some people might call me crazy, but I already think he's a Premier League legend.
Yeah,
he is.
Already. Yeah. Right. Exactly. I mean, if he was to retire today,
he'd make the Premier League.
100% he is. 100%. How good he's been, obviously not Premier League, but England.
Yeah.
The national team, he played so many tournaments. Yeah. Multiple Euros, three World Cups.
Did he finish top 10 for the Ballon d'Or one year? I think Sterling is a victim,
really. He deserves top 10.
I'm not going to argue against it, to be honest with you. He would have probably been contention for me, too, if I remembered.
Yeah.
I think he's a victim, honestly, that Raheem Sterling kind of has like this reputation around it that he just sits at the back post. Mm-hmm. He's not that talented. It's like you said, he's a system player. But
that's an elite skill.
No one else until Erling Haaland this season was putting it in the back of the net at the magnitude that Raheem Sterling was. No one else. Sané wasn't doing it, and we love Sané. Yeah. Mahrez, my guy, wasn't doing it at that level.
Yeah,
so you have to give him massive
credit. And my favorite thing is like you can't win sometimes with fans because Raheem was known at Liverpool as a player who can do everything but score.
Yeah.
Then he became a goal scorer. Oh, he only scores tapping. So he added the goals to his game that everyone was criticizing for.
That's a good point. I always say in the modern game, too, especially hard, how many players do we see that are amazing goal scorers while also being amazing all-around players? Messi, Neymar, that's the best players of all time. To be able to score that amount of goals, you typically have to sacrifice the other side of the game.
That's why the elites are able to. So like Messi's, the Neymar.
If Sterling added amazing, like dribbling, he'd be the best player in the world.
Best player in the world, exactly. 100%. So, but he made our top 10. I'm glad he did. Obviously, most of us had him around that 9th, 10th place.
You would have been in there for
Chunks had him at 7th.
That's different.
Faisal had him at 8th as well. But apart from that, everyone else had him like 9th, 10th. And then the ones that didn't have him, in 9th place now, this person, less people had him in. Actually, only two people had him in.
Mm.
And it came ninth. Wow. Because those two put him in at fourth place.
Who's this? No, it's not me.
So he's got I'll loads of points because two people had him in. It's Yaya Toure.
You see, I had him originally in my list. And I took
so
him
he's floating in and out, in and out. I was like, okay, so within the last decade, what did he... So I was looking at his achievements, individual awards. Obviously, we know how great of a player he was, but I was trying to see his best period if it crossed over the last decade. And of course, he was in this last decade an amazing player, but it was up to about 2015, 16.
16. Even 16, bro, 16 was looking like an uncle.
So I was like, ah, I can't put him in.
I did the same
thing. For me, I was exactly the same thing. For me, when it came to this top 10 list I was doing, it's all about body of work. Mm-hmm. I don't care.
In the last decade
I don't care if you had two elite years. What did you do with it? Like, if you left, like you said, if that's the case, a lot of people would have had Haaland in it 1 year, 2 years, Suarez. Like you said, Coutinho, whatever, people that, Bruno Fernandes, he had two or three
Alexis
elite seasons.
We didn't even bring up. I just even realized. Huh? Wow,
Alexis, do you come from like, I was like, I can't really look at it like that.
Yeah, yeah, facts.
That's why, like I said, a lot of elite players did not make my list. And especially, I had Yaya Toure on my short list. I said, I can't put him in ahead of these guys.
I had Yaya Toure in my original 10. Yeah. And I had him like, bro, like seventh or sixth, like very high. Oh. And I clocked, bro. 2013-14 is the season we all remember. 11-12, he was also very good, but that doesn't really fall into the last decade.
Of course,
After 13-14, bro, Yaya Toure
started declining,
Bro, there were games. I'll never forget Real Madrid versus City in the Champions League semifinal. This guy literally could not move, bro. Players were literally just like running around him. He basically couldn't be asked anymore. So if you're going body of work, like you said, it doesn't stack up to guys who have done more in this last decade than Yaya Toure.
Of course.
On his day, Yaya Toure is the best of them all. But,
like, if this list was top 10s of players' peaks in the last 10 years, then you're fair enough. That's
a whole different list. That's a whole different list. Yaya Toure didn't even make my short list. He did not even make my short
list. If you look at that, from 2013 onwards, his best years was just around that moment, but not enough to carry him over. I mean, like I said, two people had him in at fourth.
Who?
Fouzi. Seems like this is
even the last one he had. Fouzi had it in. I was like,
and Ilias.
Ilias had him at fourth.
Yeah,
fair enough.
I didn't expect that from him. Still,
he don't know ball. That's how I respect it.
Yeah, I didn't expect that from him.
He says he don't know ball, so
Him and Fouzi are the same.
But let's move on. In eighth place, everyone had this player in apart from one.
Fouzi.
And I'll tell you now, it's Fouzi.
Oh, wow.
So this person clearly deserves it because everyone else had him in. Only Fouzi didn't have him in. And it's very interesting. Why? Because it's a Liverpool player. It's Sadio Mane.
Wow.
And Fouzi's the only one that didn't have him in.
How fitting. Wow. He's the one who always gets the no love from Liverpool fans. Not enough love at Salah.
And look at that. Every single member of the podcast, plus what, Chunks, had him in apart from Fouzi.
I think I had him eighth as well.
Sadio Mane,
I had him 10th, I think.
I had him 8th. Liban, you had him 8th as well,
Yeah.
Unless you had him in the highest. No, between 7th to 10th is what everyone had him in.
Yeah. Okay,
he's so a top player, man. Top player, my days.
I remember.
Let's talk about him for a bit. Yeah, sign him on.
Bro, remember there was periods, I want to say like 1-2 year stretch where we was all going, I don't know if Mane's better than Salah. That's how good he was.
Yeah.
Salah's an all-time great.
Especially in the Champions League.
Even just last year, he got the better of him. It was kind of like, you know how Lias beat FaZe in the FIFA tournament and then beat him at Mastermind. It was kind of like that of Mane and Salah, where the AFCON beat him and then the World Cup qualifier beat him. You know? It was kind of like reminding me of that.
It's just owning, to be honest.
He's got here. He got the better of him multiple times, last year. So
it's crazy.
You never know.
To be fair with Salah and Mane, last year, Salah was unbelievable the first half of the season. I think Mane, like, you actually saw a decline. I would even say the year before that when COVID kind of hit. And Mane, like, I think it actually affected him. People were saying he might have had long COVID. And, like, the same Mane that we love, where he basically just takes on players, rips past them, scores long shots. He kind of looked like a weaker player physically.
But I agree.
In January, I remember, Diaz comes in for Liverpool. He kind of takes that position on the left, and Mane rediscovers himself as like a central player. Bro, his numbers just started
flying up.
He's a Premier League.
That's why even made Bayern even sign him, because they thought they had plans.
They
had the plans to use him centrally, but obviously it hasn't worked out.
Mane is elite, man. Honestly, when he was at his best, bro, I was someone who actually said, okay, Salah will get you more numbers, but in terms of an all around 90 minute threat,
better player.
Mane is more of like your all-action midfield, like the winger, for example. He's just going to take your fullback and go at him time after.
And he was he was one of the few wingers. He was one of the few wingers that cooked Kyle Walker.
Bro.
Whenever he played, it was cooked food.
Yeah.
And you don't really get that.
He's just so powerfully rapid. Like, that's the thing with him, bro. He just run sprint
even
past
even I know this is Premier League though. Yeah, even the Champions League run when they won the Champions League.
I think he's
Mane
best
was the problem. Yeah, it wasn't Salah. Mane was the best player.
Unbelievable.
I mean, he was crazy.
Unbelievable player.
I mean, yeah, but he deserves to. Yeah, he deserves his flowers.
He definitely has to be in the top 10. I'm happy he's in the top.
I mean, yeah, comfortably. I mean, everyone had him in. So
is he in 100 club?
Bar one.
Don't
Golden Boot winner, by the way.
Golden Boot.
I don't think he is in 100 club yet. I don't think he is.
But he won't be if he's not yet.
He's
not gonna come back. Probably not. But in seventh place, we still haven't got someone that everyone's had in yet. In seventh place,
I blame Fuzi for that, man.
One, two, three people didn't have this guy in.
Wow.
But the reason he's seventh and above Mane is because one person had him at third, so it pushed him up quite a lot.
You know what? I don't get it, Sharks. Before you go,
yeah.
I have someone that keeps doing the list, whatever, does not respect KDB, Kane, or Salah.
Why?
In terms, because for me,
oh, because you've seen too many second thirds and that.
Too many second thirds.
So it's interesting.
So in the last decade, me personally, as we'll assume, those are the top three. Obviously, you can split them whichever way you want, but having seen so many people not change
their. Yeah, I know what you're trying to say. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting to see as we go up.
Don't even look at that brother that I'm thinking of. Don't
But
you dare. The
player in seventh, like I said, three people don't have him in.
Expose them.
Anyone from this table?
Expose them.
It might be me.
It's Renedy, Faisal, and Liban.
Oh, why did I have them?
Yeah, expose them. Expose him.
Expose me. Damn, I set myself up there.
David Silva.
Oh, come on.
So you had Gundogan and not David Silva.
First of all, I completely forgot about David Silva.
Because he's the forgotten one.
But now let me think about it. I need to think about it now. Yeah, because when did he leave?
2018, bro.
No, 2020.
2020?
No, 2019. 2020 is when he left.
1920
is his last season.
He joined early City days.
Now my list might be different.
Yeah.
Bro, but I completely forgot about him though.
I completely forgot about him.
I've always said on the pod, he's me so personally, underrated. He's the greatest City player I've seen.
Dude, I'm not gonna lie to you. My list could now potentially change if I had him.
Bro, that guy,
El Mago. Damn. He's amazing, bro. Man.
I don't care even for him if he doesn't score goals or assists. I think he changed that.
He's a genius,
bro. In the Premier League, they said he changed that small.
He gave people like Lias hope.
Come on, man. We got Ilias on the pod. We got Felix Vida.
You're here, bro.
Nah, fair enough. Nah, David Silva, bro. And here's the thing with Silva too. I think Pep almost gave him like a revival in his career because I think he was starting to like dwindle a little bit. And Pep kind of brought him in 4-3-3 KDB, him and Fernandinho. I think what was it? I think it might have been 17-18. Or maybe it was 18-19. One of those two seasons, he was City's best player. Bro, he was crazy, man.
I think he got City player of the season one of those years.
One of those 2 years.
Unbelievable, man. He got City player of the season in one of those years. I can't remember which one
it was. That was a joke of a midfielder. He was a problem. I can't lie. There was only two players I was scared of every time we play City. Aguero was one. That was Silva. When I saw those two on the pitch, I'm like, it's a long day.
But Prime Yaya, you must be scared of him.
Yeah, look, Prime Yaya, but
for how long?
You got midfielders. You got midfielders that can match up. Like,
really?
Yeah.
Who did you have?
Darren Fletcher.
Pogba came in that year. We had Michael Carrick at that time.
Hold on. First of all, let me go. Pogba came in when Yaya Toure was cooked.
I know.
Carrick could never, and I'm the big Carrick could never physically compete with Yaya Toure.
No, I'm not saying physically.
I'm
not saying that. I'm saying there were days that our midfield had the better. We had the better of them.
Better collectively.
I'm not saying individually we never had the better of Yaya Toure. I'm just saying, like as a midfield, I'm saying like the two players that I felt like, yo, these guys are just we could
make
do
something out.
We could do whatever we want, but they can literally in the moment change the game. Yeah. It was David Silva and Aguero. Those were the two that I was like, yo.
I put Yaya in that conversation.
Is it? You put Yaya?
Bro, Yaya had the ability when he wants to just picks up the ball at half field and literally can just run through your entire team. That's a joke.
Yeah.
That guy, man. What a special player, man. Special.
Would have made your list then if you didn't forget him.
Yeah, I think he would have made my list.
He's so under. It doesn't surprise me that people forgot him. For me, he's always forgotten when you talk about City greats. We talk about De Bruyne, Aguero, even company.
What's that tuna?
Yeah, Silva.
Deservedly.
He's so good.
It's the weirdest statues.
It looks weird.
They were ugly.
Yeah,
I went and saw those, brother.
Yeah, it's barely a statue.
No worse than Ronaldo's.
Metal. That was amazing. That was amazing.
Madeira.
Ronaldo's got probably the worst statue of all time.
Let's get into sixth place now. Once again, still looking for a player that everyone has in.
I think we'll get them.
Because this player, everyone has him in bar one again.
He's definitely
going to guess who?
Fuzzy?
Fuzzy.
Of course right. he is.
Right, so Fuzzy's the new Alfie. Yeah, you can't be listening.
Nah, it's West and Alfie, though.
Yeah.
West and Alfie.
Everyone has this guy in bar for Fuzzy.
Yeah.
And Stars, you have him in at the highest at all of us. It's N'Golo Kante.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. He should be on the list.
What's his position in our list?
Sixth.
Sixth. Well, I think that's around where I had him, to be honest.
You had him at fourth.
Yeah. I had him at...
I had him sixth.
I had him at sixth.
You though. Had him...
Sixth as well.
I think seventh
I
had him.
I had a sixth. Yeah, everyone had him sixth.
Yeah, I think I had him seventh.
No, no, no. It was... Fouad had him at fifth. Stars had him fourth. Haseeb fifth. Ren fifth. Lias eighth. You had him at the lowest.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
No, but hold on. Here's my disclaimer. Yeah. And I told Haseeb this before. My, I think it was 8 through 5... were all interchangeable. I could not for the life of me decide which is too close. It's too close. Yeah,
for me, when like you said, going on N'Golo Kante, if you're talking about body work, that guy was like 5-6 years straight being one of the best.
I disagree.
It wasn't 5-6 years.
I disagree.
How long?
That's what the reason.
I'll say probably
3 years, to be honest. Yeah.
I'll say
2015, 16.
2015 to about 2019.
No, what was the other
one? 2020.
2021.
And then 2021 he came back.
The match in semis and finals in big games.
Towards obviously 2020, 2021. There was injuries, but when he played, it was N'Golo Kante.
I disagree. We had that period where Sarri came in and people were thinking, oh, he's playing Kante in the wrong role. And to be honest with you, Sarri actually found the new Kante. Okay,
yeah,
he
boxed
the box.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was not good. Well that season, though.
Very well. Mm.
I think he still played well.
We're talking about all-timer role. Yeah. We're talking about fifth best in Premier League history. Kante was good those years.
Yeah.
Lampard, he was good those years. The best years, Kante was Leicester, Conte the first year, and the Champions League winning year. In those years, I think you could argue he had more importance to his team than anyone else on this list. Like, he is the heart and soul of everything he's on. But he didn't do it for me at that elite level, year in, year out, like a few of these other guys.
But I think he embodied that position, though.
I know what you're trying to say. I think that level, I don't think he played that consistently every year.
Yeah.
But I still feel like even the years where he slightly dropped off, I still feel he was still like a good
But he was still level ahead of others.
He
was still level ahead of a lot of players. Like you said, you'll never find...
I think the COVID...
difficult is you'll never find a player that won player of the year, like won the league back-to-back.
World Cup
and then... one player of the year at his position at DM.
I think he had the best 3 years in the history of football.
Winning.
If you really think about it.
Best, my best 5 years in general.
Yeah. Bro,
at 25, he was still playing in second tier of French football.
But my question for you guys.
And then by 30, he's won the Prem, the Champions League, the World Cup. He's part of a six-man club that's only...
Europa League 2 years.
Yeah. Only six men have done that in history of football.
Yeah.
My question is, though, is he a better footballer? Like, is he a better player than David Silva?
No.
See, a better player.
I don't like that because one plays further back, and then the other.
A better player.
I'm not asking who looks nicer on the eye. I'm saying who's the better player between who is a better player in the Premier League between him and David Silva.
But I'm always gonna favor the attacker than the DM, if that makes sense. I'll be real. Like, if you ask me who's the better player, Busquets or Iniesta,
I'm not even asking you.
I'm gonna look at.
I'm not even asking who's more talented. Who did more? I think it's David Silva, bro. I think David Silva did more in the Premier League.
I think David Silva has more, like a longer...
Yeah, he has a longer thing. He won more. Like,
ooh, I get what you're saying. Ooh, yeah. But I know in terms of a longer body of work, if that what you're trying to...
I'm just asking in general, who's been the better Premier League player?
I think peak, if you compare peaks, though,
Kante's
got a better peak.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm not with you on that one.
I'm thinking David Silva over Kante all time. Yeah, yeah, I'm thinking David Silva.
Mm.
But like I said,
I already told you, David Silva was one of my favorite players. But when it comes, like I said, when it comes to what he did, for Leicester, early Chelsea, carried on, and never really, like you'll never hear, oh, he dropped a stinker. It's always, it's always at a top level. It goes, like one man in midfield.
Yeah.
I'll say this, right, about N'Golo Kante. Bro. If there's a big game, like a final tomorrow, whatever, the big game for Chelsea, or big game for France, and N'Golo Kante is one of the first players I'm picking. He is a big game player to the max, bro.
Yeah, 100%. Facts.
But should we get into the top five?
Yeah.
I'm excited. In fifth place, it is Mr. You're not going to be happy about this. Sergio Aguero.
Oh, I thought you were going to say a different name. That's crazy. But I'm less unhappy than I thought I was going to be.
Damn. Actually, you as well, both of you have him in a second.
Yeah.
Wow.
Aguero fifth. So what we're saying, or what these people are saying, Harry Kane is better than Aguero. That's what we're saying here.
So he's not the best goal scorer in the last decade?
If you have a Harry Kane over Aguero,
best shooter.
That's what you're insinuating.
Quite a few
in the last decade.
Hmm?
Huh? Aguero in the last decade.
I've got him on the list. That's the first thing I can go. Like, I've got Harry Kane higher.
Wow.
I'm not gonna. A lot of people have Harry Kane high, of course, including myself, including Stars.
Wow.
You know? To me, that's crazy.
I don't agree.
Including,
yeah, I don't agree.
I that's mean, crazy. So obviously the reason why it's been pushed down is Fuad's got him in at eighth.
Huh? Eighth.
Fuad's got him eighth.
Where is it? Hold on. Can I ask Fuad a question? Back, yeah, I need to ask you a question.
Yeah, come.
Don't ask a question. Come back.
Hold on. Come here. Guy, I have a question for you. You were nodding when I said you guys think Harry Kane is better than Aguero.
That's me personally.
Yeah. Okay, so where is Aguero on your
list?
Aguero is on my list.
Where is he? Yeah,
you take my thing
where on. Is he in your list?
Eighth.
I had him eighth, yeah.
Oh, so I thought you said you had Kane at eighth.
No, he's got Aguero eighth.
I've got where Aguero do you eighth. I had
Davis, you have Aguero eighth.
That's what I said.
I had Kante ahead of him. Some of the other names as well, but those were the two names. And then
he had Mane ahead of him.
Get the hell out of here. I don't want to see you anymore.
That one was a little bit
I don't want to see you anymore. Get out of here, bro.
I got like, I messed up on that one. I should have rotated
Aguero,
that one. Yeah.
Aguero should have been ahead of Mane on my list. Still, yeah. But still, I think, especially when you're talking about Harry Kane, I'm sorry, but we're talking about the all-time Premier League goal scorer by the time he retires. Okay. Yeah. And then you look at, this is a guy who used to be a pure nine. The way he's changed his game, the way he's been able to elevate it. I'm sorry, you lot can shake your heads all you want. But Aguero.
I'm not as upset about that as I am that you have Aguero at seventh. That for me, you can have Kane above Aguero. I disagree, but whatever.
Aguero
at seventh is for me ludicrous.
I love the Aguero.
Bro, Aguero is 20 goals guaranteed every single season while only playing, 28, 27 games. So his consistency and his efficiency is.
I agree.
It's all time great. Hold on, I'm not done. Aguero, in terms of big game, is the best top big six goal scorer in Premier League history. No debate about it whatsoever. He has the trophies to represent it.
Best goals to game ratio.
Best foreign goal scorer in Premier League history. Seventh is ludicrous, bro. It is blasphemous.
It's great names.
David Big Mo. Oh my God, bro.
And if you want to go for the top five as well, there's some serious names on there, bro.
Nah, I'm sorry,
the game is the game, man. Nah. Listen, man didn't have Kyle Walker in there, innit?
Any guy here, blood?
That's Spurs bias. That's what it is.
Wow.
Yeah.
You deserve that.
He's banged his head on the side.
Yeah.
Where was seventh?
Nice behavior.
I mean, he made it fifth in STS combined list. He had him at second, which is
with that one still.
Obviously you're disappointed.
Yeah.
But this one actually is more interesting because we're going into fourth place now. This player, someone doesn't have him in, but everyone else does. So I was gonna guess who doesn't have him in? It's Fuizzi.
What are you doing here, man?
Yeah.
Of course he doesn't.
But on the other spectrum,
I know who it is.
Someone has him in at first. So that's crazy, isn't it? This was the biggest discrepancy.
Am I going to be upset at this?
Someone at this table is going to be upset. In fourth place of the SDS combined top 10 players in the Premier League of the last decade.
Don't do this.
Is Eden Hazard.
Good.
You know what? I'm kind of happy. Fuzzy did what I remember. Good. I told Fuzzy did something that I wish I could
like,
do.
Like, share, subscribe, notifications.
Wait, come on, come
sit.
Let's
go. He's coming at first. Yeah.
Go out first. He's a sicko. He's sick.
You know what?
You think he's first? Come sit down, man.
What are you doing, by the way? Faisal should definitely have Hazard first.
Faisal loves Hazard, but he's not stupid. He's not delusional.
This is ridiculous.
You go first. You going first?
Let's go in third, but he's a Hazard fan.
And I respect it.
Maybe speak to
Harry Kane is above Hazard.
Hazard fan.
I'm gonna throw
bro,
up.
Bro, in terms of ability, wonderful. Prime, wonderful. Bro, we're talking about consistency. No.
Hazard didn't have consistency in the Prem.
Took 2 years off.
Third.
I've got Eden third.
Who do you have above
I've got two
him? Is Harry Kane above?
I've got Harry Kane fourth.
Okay.
But in terms of, I've got two players. I got fifth. Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay, fine. Yeah, cool.
I've got
better.
Two players above Eden Hazard who's done it for 10 years more than him. It's that simple.
Hold on. They've done it 10 years more than him.
More than
are you insane?
Remember that lie when I tell you who has
10 years more than him? Bro, he's not.
Okay, no.
Rephrase that. 10 years, bro. He's not 50 years old.
Okay, thank you.
I love Eden Hazard.
Nah, go away. You love Eden Hazard. Chelsea fans, you lost the bet.
Shall I be honest with you? First is crazy.
He's first. He's easily first.
That's just
you know what I mean.
No, he's not easily first. Let me rephrase that. I'm more upset right now that Harry Kane is above him. I can hear Hazard not being first, but I'm glad you rephrased yourself, because bro, this whole thing that Hazard doesn't have the consistency in the Premier League. From when Hazard stepped into the league, from Eden Hazard, I would say 2014-15.
Yeah, he took years off.
Hold on. 2014-15 to 2018-19 when he left, he was the best player in the league.
No, he was, bro.
But throughout the whole time, like, yes, he was the best player.
There was one period where he fell off.
Outside of that, from 14-15 to 18-19, he's the best game.
Look, Mourinho was class.
Conte was class. Sarri was class at the end of his Chelsea career.
I think ability wise.
Forget about ability wise. This is what I hate. I'm not going to let you finish this. Before you even talk about ability, you know what ability. This whole thing about ability of Hazard, bro, is more than just ability, bro. This guy's match winning capability. He can win you an entire game, drop a 10 out of 10 without scoring or assisting. So I don't want to hear about ability.
I agree. I don't want to hear about ability. Okay, here I want to say to you. You see how you said 2014 to 2018 and 19, right?
Yeah.
So how many of those seasons could you say that Hazard was actually the best player that season?
I'm telling you, bar, what is it, 15, 16? Every other season, bro.
I might sound crazy. I could tell you seasons where I feel like Alexis was a better player.
No!
Seasons where Mo Salah was a better player.
No, I could tell you. Alexis was the better player.
I'm just saying there's seasons where they were the better.
So Alexis was better than him.
Alexis' efficiency output was ridiculous.
Bro, Alexis Sanchez, let me tell you.
He literally carried Arsenal at one point.
He carried them to the fifth. Alexis Sanchez, bro, has never been better than Hazard. Let me tell you why.
Yeah.
Alexis Sanchez, his best season came when Arsenal came fifth. Alexis Sanchez's best play never resulted, like, he didn't contribute enough to make Arsenal were at their best when Ozil was at his best. Hazard, bro, his best play elevates Arsenal, elevates Chelsea. Alexis Sanchez's best play elevates Alexis. It never elevated Arsenal the way.
No, but that's a different argument.
No, but when you're talking about who had the better season, Eden Hazard elevates his garbage teams.
I was saying, if we're comparing individual to individual, I'm trying to get the team thing out of it one second. Like, I'm saying, individual to individual.
The aspect of the goal of winning is to win team sports, bro.
Yeah, but output wise, because I'm saying, like, as an output, because there's seasons where it's hard to remove the team aspect, even when I throw the team thing in, there's Mo Salah, okay,
Salah can
there's
hear.
Harry Kane,
no,
yeah, there's also
Kevin De Bruyne,
no, but there's so many players that you could argue that had better seasons than Hazard. They're better than Hazard player to player.
Name the season De Bruyne had when they were in the league together that he had.
I'm not saying De Bruyne. I think Hazard's the best Belgian to ever play in terms of, like, ability wise. I'm not saying that. I'm saying, though, player to player.
This isn't bad, bro.
Salah and De Bruyne have earned their stripes at that level. If you want to put them above, yeah. I don't agree, but fair enough. Harry Kane has not shown.
No, Harry Kane might not be next. He might not be on the list.
Don't lie to me in my face, Sharky.
I don't know, man. For me, Hazard, good player, but I think the ones that I have above him, I think they've earned their right to be above him. I think they've done more than him.
Where did you have him?
I had him at fifth, I believe.
How far did I have him at fifth?
Hazard.
I had him at fifth.
Sixth.
Oh my God.
I don't think Eden Hazard's an amazing player. Nah.
Eden Hazard is being killed right now because of his years at Madrid.
He's getting cooked because of his years at Madrid.
Because if you had this opinion that Hazard was the sixth best player of the decade in 2018-19 when he left,
Hazard. How about that? You know how he doesn't like Van Dijk? That's me with Hazard.
Your agenda doesn't make any sense, bro.
With Hazard, me and Hazard.
I think it's me and Hazard.
Me, I hate this comps. Why is this comps coming out now? The Chelsea comps now. You tell me.
My biggest criticism of Hazard has always been his output, his ability. I've never questioned. Ability wise, he's probably better than the majority of players. His output for you, goals, assists. When you play a game of football,
On average in a game, 2.5 goals are scored max. Two goals, 1-1, plus two goals, right? Mm. There's 22 players on the pitch. Mm. Every single game, it's unlikely you're going to have a goal or an assist. Right? Yeah. Only two players can even have a goal, or three players will be involved in a goal every single game. Mm. So his output, unless he's a top striker or
like someone like Salah, who like is a mm-hmm. goal scorer, mm-hmm. he's not going to get a goal or assist every game. So you don't just measure on goals or assists.
I'm not
players like Hazard.
He's a creative player.
Players like Hazard. Yeah. He creates the person who made the assist. Yeah. He creates for the
Hazard. Okay. Hazard
he
draws players onto
him. He draws three players off him for someone to make that third man running.
Rebound. Let me ask you this. How many players in the Premier League can you name that a coach has literally told them, I'm going to scrap my game plan and put my players on you?
I'm not disputing none of that. Everything you said, I agree with. But if you're looking at in terms of, look, for example, with Hazard, we're not comparing him to, I don't want to say their names, but there's certain players that we're comparing him to now. It's all marginal. It's margins. So I have to now look at the numbers, because the players that are on that list for me in that top five, they're all exceptional players.
Well, I think we're going to have Hazard, look, I'm saying,
Hazard for me, there's only one player that I think ability wise is better than Hazard. One player, Messi. Messi, Neymar, I think Tubbs' ability. Neymar, we could argue Neymar as well. But I'm saying...
So you think Hazard's the third best technical player?
That I've seen.
I don't beg it. I've seen with my eyes.
Messi, Neymar, and... Yeah, you could argue Neymar as well. Messi, Neymar, and...
Hazard,
yeah. In terms of ability, we're talking about ability, but look at the difference between Messi and Neymar.
How long back are we stretching for this?
Last 15 years, let's say. Last 15 years, yeah. So,
like Iniesta, all
that. Of course, the midfielders. Like,
I'm talking about attackers.
But I'm saying, compare Messi, like, to obviously, okay, Messi's out of this world, but Messi and Hazard. Messi can do the influence games the way Hazard can. But I'm saying Hazard doesn't need to get 60 goals this season. That's crazy. That's not what Messi and Ronaldo were doing. It's not normal. But if he was getting on average between 20 to 25, he would be clear dominant, the best player in the last 10, 15 years of the Premier League. Easily for me. But if you're only getting 10, 15,
some players like Hazard.
Most of the players, you're affecting your own vision of the sport.
There's thousands and thousands and tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of football players. If you only use one metric to measure every single person and different systems, different type of players, different this, different that, you're limiting yourself and your view of the game. Because someone like Hazard and other players, you can't just go output, yes, no, tick box,
Sterling should be higher than others.
Because Sterling was big in my head, 30 goal season and stuff.
Okay.
But no one put Sterling
on the right mind.
Because it's just, you know.
But different factors. What did you say at the beginning of the video? Hey, Shark, what did you say at the beginning of the video? You said that everyone used to going to use different metrics to put their list,
right? That's what makes a sport amazing.
But some are going to weigh more heavy than others. People on this list, their numbers you can't ignore.
Of course.
For me, Harry Kane's one of them. I can't ignore his numbers. So he has to be in that list. And I'm not even the biggest Harry Kane fan, but I know that he has to be on this list.
You still feel like
I never said. You know, I never said. You know, listen, okay, can we set the record straight?
Before you set the record straight, so it makes sense. In third place, you have Harry Kane. Okay, go.
Harry Kane. Okay. I never, ever. I just want to set the record straight because I never said that statement. My statement was that at the time, I can admit that maybe now I'll take that back, but I said at the time that
when they won the league,
they were in the same tier bracket. That's what I said. They were in the tier of strikers. I said Harry Kane is not with Lewandowski, Benzema, Suarez. He's with the Lukakus, the Higuaín.
With time now.
That level.
With a bit more time.
That was like 2020, 21 times. Now that's slightly changed now. Now I would
Kane's elevated. Now, we stayed the same.
Yeah, that's exactly. So now my opinion would change. But at that time, that was my assessment at the time. But I never ever once said Lukaku's better than Harry Kane. That's just something that man have just created and just ran with it.
Yeah, someone said that.
They just ran with it.
You know your thing that you talk about Harry Kane and Lukaku. Would you say more of Harry Kane still stays where he is, but Lukaku's just gone down the table.
I think Harry Kane slightly elevated. But my problem with Harry Kane, and I've always said, my problem with Harry Kane is that, yes, he's a great goal scorer. I don't dispute that. He's an amazing goal scorer, great player. Yes. But my issue with Harry Kane has always been is his mentality in terms of winning in big games. like his clutchness. I think that's a big aspect. I don't rate it.
That's the thing. That's the worst
part. I don't rate it. I think he's a loser.
I think he's a loser. I really do. I think he's got a serial loser, bro.
I want to go that far.
I'll agree with you based on what his decision at the end of the summer is. Yeah, if Harry Kane stays at Spurs,
he's a serial loser.
No, but I'm saying his mentality as a football player on the pitch throughout a season. I think he's one of the best. Has one of the best mentalities in this country.
Okay.
As a player, for example. What he's done for Spurs, he's gone, like he's achieved more than, so the maximum that you could do for Spurs is, let's say here, right? Because it's Spurs.
Yeah.
He's done more than that consistently
for
the last decade throughout. So that's pure Juice's mentality. Because I think his ability is there and his mentality pushes him up even more. Because I think he's a player who wants to be one of the greatest ever, right? Then I think his decision-making outside of the field has been wrong. Maybe bad advice. Maybe he had too much fake promises. Maybe Daniel Levy been held him hostage. We don't know. Mm. As a football player on the pitch, I think he has one of the best mentalities we've seen as a striker.
Okay,
from where he and bear in mind, his professional career. Mm. I mean, as a top level, started a bit later than
22.
Currently, now with the players starting now. Yeah. Haaland, you're seeing now, is one of the best strikers in the world. Harry Kane was just coming on for Soldado at that point. You know? So I think to do that and where he's become now, probably England's greatest ever goal scorer, Premier League's greatest ever goal scorer. Okay, the winning as a club thing, that's different. But I think as a player, I think one of the best mentalities ever.
I think, okay.
That's why I've got him in at third. And
you
I had him above
third.
I've got
him at fourth, I think.
You had him in at fourth. You remember your list perfectly. Ilias had him at ninth, which is a bit concerning. That's an interesting list.
You see, Harry Kane with the point you made. I agree with everything you said, by the way. I don't dispute everything you said. I think he's a great goal
Ilias
scorer.
Had him at ninth.
Yeah, he's a sicko.
Ilias had Harry Kane at ninth. Ilias' list is very confused. Been confusing me all day, I'll be honest. I'm not going to lie to you. Yeah, but Karen.
No, I was just saying that, like, with his goal scoring record, I don't dispute everything you say. Majority, I agree with. Yeah, but what I'm saying is, in terms of being clutch, I think at a lot of big moments he hasn't stepped up.
Okay,
I can't really.
So what's this?
I can't really count in my hand how many big moments Harry Kane has had.
Because for you, a big moment is a final.
No, not finals. Big games, like in terms of like semi-finals, finals, England semi-finals, finals. Like Tottenham semi-finals, finals. Like I can't remember a Harry Kane game where I said, "Oh, that was a mad." Like
I can remember many Harry Kane games. Man City last season.
No, but that's like a Premier League game.
It's not a big game.
But in a sense of okay, look at their seasons. Like the seasons they were having. I don't think that game.
Not
really,
the season. I just
when
went
you
by.
Really look at. I know, the 3-2 one. I know. So for me, okay. When you look at it by the end of the season, the game didn't really... I'm talking about a moment where, for example, you're talking about the semi-finals, the finals, like the England, when we were England-France, for example.
He scored a penny in that game. I was forgetting he scored a penny in that game.
Okay, that wasn't the penny that meant... Yeah.
The thing with Kane is he's such a good penalty scorer that him missing in that big moment...
When he never misses...
Holy Glorious don't really say pens.
That's what I'm saying. The Harry Kane is one of the best pen takers we've ever seen.
You know what I said? That game, listen. That game,
but I wouldn't want him in the
class. Ask Arsenal fans. We know that. He scores penalties every game.
You know,
guaranteed four games.
Yeah, but okay.
You know with this guy. Yeah. You know with this guy. I understand where he's coming from. With this,
I understand as well. I'm just trying to.
Yeah, of course.
Within this list,
you know,
he deserves.
No. I know you do.
Within this list, he deserves where he is. I think third, fourth, whatever. If you want to put third, fourth, fifth, but like you said, if you're totality wise, if you're now that you make, because obviously your argument is, and I'm with you in terms of when it is Champions League, because he didn't play home and away, he didn't play semi final Champions League. It was Lucas Moura for Ajax.
Man City,
the one before that, he came back for the World thing. Euros, he didn't really do much. Italy, whatever it was.
The Euros was a big one.
He was having stinkers.
He didn't score in the group.
He was having stinkers. Raheem had to slightly carry us that tournament. So that's what I'm saying to you. Like,
I'll be real, bro. I can never put him over Aguero. I can never put him over guys like Lewandowski in terms of like what they've done in their career. Suarez. Like Kane is unbelievable. And I have no doubt that when he gets to a big club, if he ever does make that move, we'll see him in these big moments putting goals away.
But, you know what,
but at the end of the day, I've seen Aguero in these moments. I've seen Suarez in these moments. I can't give Kane the benefit of the doubt time after time.
Yeah,
when I've seen those guys actually do it.
Yeah, but you've seen Aguero at City and Suarez at Barca. Kane, that's the move, like you said, I agree. Fair enough, but at Spurs, unfortunately, that's a hypothetical. Yeah, but
we're
that's
saying,
what I'm saying, though,
Kane.
How many... Okay, so...
About England?
But also... This team is playing for. They're not a team that go regularly deep in tournaments. So if you're having a big game, like a big final once every 5 years, but it's not Sharky, a regular thing.
Kane, what I'm saying is,
City are always going to be
playing at Spurs with one of the best teams in the world, but let's not front. Yeah. There was a period where Spurs were competing.
They were top, they were top two.
They were competing for the league. There was about two years.
Where they were definitely one of the best teams in Europe. You could say there was about 2 years where they were definitely one of the best teams in Europe. Come on, bro.
They had a good tournament run. They had a good championship.
No, no, no. No, but no, there were 2 years
from like 2016 to about
did you say Arsenal are one of the better teams in Europe right now?
Right now, on form, current
why,
form, yes.
Why couldn't Spurs be one in current form when they came second twice in? Well, I think they came third 1 year. Yeah. But they were
of course, they're up.
They're one of the best. So my point is, Kane was playing in Capital One Cup Finals against Chelsea. Kane was playing in big games that if they won could have potentially catapulted Spurs to their first league title. So you can't say he didn't have the opportunity, bro.
Okay, what about someone like Henry and how many finals and stuff would he turn up at? No one's ever going to respect Henry.
I would never. But that's my point. It's not just about finals. I agree with you. I'm saying even semi-finals.
But okay, with Henry, I could tell you, but I could tell you Madrid away. Like, you know, big games come to my head straight away. Juventus. So it's like, I got so many moments of Henry where I'm like, oh, the where he flicked it and did the volley against United. Like,
yeah, but it's about
like,
goals. Like, how many,
for example, the semi-final against when he took you guys to the Champions League final, that's a big game. The Juventus, again, that was to get you, you know what I mean? Those are all big games.
I'm a big fan of Henry.
I can't think of Harry Kane Brazil, having those super moments.
France, Brazil as well. He scored in it in the World Cup, 06.
Semi.
Was it? Oh, yes, he did. Can I ask this?
I'm not asking. I'm not asking you to prove me wrong, but Henry, I know how great he is. I'm saying, because you're talking about finals and that. As long as he's not someone who scored in many finals. Yeah. And, but no one will ever say.
But he's got big games.
But seriously, he's like the Henry show.
How many Harry Kane shows have you seen?
I have to. That's not more Spurs though.
That's what I'm telling you. And it's marketing. Henry gets pushed.
England.
But I have to ask this question.
You can't just say Spurs.
He's done great. He's done great for England.
Bro,
welcome to score a gold boot. Go.
Panama. Panama.
Croatia.
So did he do the draw? Did he do the draw?
I want Panama. I want Tunisia. I want
Panama. You're using Panama.
I agree with you. You can't win. But I have to ask you this question. Yeah. What are we...
Okay, so why is Hurricane above Hazard?
No, it's not even about Hazard, because Hazard, you know what, they're different players.
Forget about Hazard, man!
I'm not gonna bring up Hazard. Hazard, they're different players.
Yeah.
You're gonna bring up goals, whatever. Aguero versus Kane.
Oh, yeah.
What are we putting Kane above Aguero for? Because in almost every single metric that you can stack them up against,
Aguero wins.
Aguero comes up trumps, bro. I don't understand how you can put
Aguero higher than Kane.
Aguero higher, bro.
I had Aguero higher.
I'm not involved in that conversation still.
That makes no sense to me, bro. That makes no sense to me.
I'd love to hear. You ain't gonna worry about me.
You had Kane at third, Aguero at fifth.
Oh, you're sicko.
Zach says me, third or fifth.
Who would you have at fourth?
I'd Hazard
in between them.
Brother, you had Hazard one, bro.
Hazard is so much better than Kante. It's unbelievable. Oh my days. Kante himself would not tell you he's better than Hazard.
Yeah, yeah. Hazard one, man. You can't argue that.
My days. Hey. Let the hate outside of your heart. I really like Hazard. Like you said,
he was the only player. He was the only player that was like Ballon d'Or worthy. Like you can put him in that conversation with the top guys. Not necessarily be better than them, but he can kind of sit on that table in the Premier League. Other than that,
that's nonsense.
Other than that,
that's nonsense. That's nonsense.
Eden Hazard, you can't finish 10th and you're not injured. You played the whole season, you finished 10th.
And N'Golo Kante just finished 12th.
But he's injured though.
He's injured.
Hazard,
what did I say?
I said Eden Hazard played the season. He wasn't injured and he finished 10th.
He's never injured that season. He was never injured that season.
I don't think so. From what I remember, he's putting stinkers after stinkers.
I don't know. I don't focus on Chelsea.
Same. Apparently, he does. Hazard must be Algerian or something.
Yeah, that's what I'm going to say.
Hazard must be Algerian or something.
He's got the same trim as him. Hazard is.
I would have thought he's Algerian at this point, though.
It makes me sick.
He gives me North African vibes.
He does. I think he is. I think his bloodline definitely
must be.
He
has to be.
100%.
Mental. Unreal player.
Hey, but that was
God given talent. That's about it.
It's been getting from Aguero through to Kane so far, from fifth to third, has been very, very.
Maybe the Aguero one's the one I'm a bit upset with. I should have put him a bit higher.
I had Aguero second.
The top two are more or less unanimous.
And I think the top two for me.
I think this is recency bias.
Who said?
It was Kane.
Okay.
It was Kane the third. Everyone had him in their list, obviously. Ilias had him at ninth, which was Kane. Ilias had him at ninth.
So who's got? I want to know who's got the lowest one.
And the highest for Kane was Fouad. He had him at second.
Fouad had Kane at second.
Yeah, that was the
highest. You flipping casual.
That
man.
Was the highest.
Oh my days.
Yeah, Kane at
old
second.
Old man.
Yeah. He had Kane at second. So wow. I love these top tens, guys. By the way, because it's like everyone. There's so many people on this podcast, and like we were saying before, everyone measures players differently, and they rank things higher. Like some people might rank stats, some might rank eye
hatred
test
as well.
Some might have just personal bias, personal hatred. So when we put a combined list and you see where they end up, it's beautiful to see. I love it.
You know how Levan was saying Van Dijk, Nihau. Has to be Hazard as well.
Maybe even India.
Namaste as well.
And namaste, yeah.
Namaste.
The way you eat in India.
Or maybe Salaam Alaikum.
Salaam Alaikum.
Get some money there.
Yeah, cool.
See, the way you're talking about Hazard. This is crazy.
Bro, it's a win-win.
It's 2023.
Y'all don't respect
You could bring Facebook on
it.
It's a decade
debate. And you get a big. Money. Come on. That's unreal. Come on, that's a good combo, man.
Basil,
the biggest Hazard fan I know.
No, he's not. How about that? How about now I'm the biggest one?
He's not Algerian, bro. I'm telling you that now.
It's not about being Algerian, bro. He's a great player, bro.
He's not from Canada as well, you know that. Well, like,
he's from Belgium.
Belgium, bro.
You know, Kante ain't from Hargeisa either, bro. You don't gotta write
it. He's not, bro. He's from the better.
The one thing though, in Hazard, one of the greatest names for a footballer I've ever heard in my life.
I thought you were going to say the greatest backs.
But names, what a name.
The name, yeah. Eden Hazard.
Eden Hazard.
Vogue
is the only one that turned up.
He loves the family, bro.
He's the best, but no one's seen him.
Yeah,
he loves the fam, bro.
But
Vogue has had a decent career.
Let's get into the top. All right, okay. So that got a bit heated, but got fun. That's when I love the podcast the most. When we're all having that Aguero Hazard Kane, that segment of this episode. That's not love this podcast the most.
I give him the Aguero Kane. I'll put my hands up.
I should respect Aguero.
At least they changed him.
I don't know how you can argue.
But Eden Hazard, if you could go lower, I would put him lower. I'm happy with him.
Just because of him.
Him and the rest of them Eden Hazard fans.
You don't appreciate good football. I get it. It's fine.
Here we go again. If it's not his opinion, it's wrong.
I get it. If you don't like good football,
I'm a casual.
Maybe.
With this Hazard thing, you're the odd one out. I'm not going to lie. There's 10 people that got involved in this. You're the only one that hasn't been first. And actually,
I got to work harder to convince the man.
He's not Algerian. He's not Canadian.
And even more so, no one's even got him in at second, so no one's even close to agreeing.
What did I say, though? Salah, De Bruyne, if you want to put them in, I have no problem, really. Even Aguero. Okay. It's Kane that I have a problem with. That's it.
Cool. Okay. I think Kane deserves... Yeah, deserves it, man.
But this guy pro Kane, this guy pro Hazard. We should have mixed it between them.
I put Kane over Hazard.
Right? Yeah,
I did as well. I put Kane over Hazard for my own reasons.
Yeah, his eyes twitching. He's like,
he's twitching.
The football purists are like devastated.
You know when I watch Kane,
I love Kane. Kane is football purist too.
That's
for me.
For me, when I watch
striker,
yeah, I understand. When I watch Kane, it's like watching beauty. When you watch Hazard,
watching beauty is crazy.
It's like Saturday thingy.
Nah, that is going too far.
Go too far.
I say pop football.
You rattled me already.
I'm just trying to get to it.
I'm already rattled, bro. You don't got to keep going.
But let's get into the top two.
Yes.
I think everyone knows who the top two are going to be, but we've got some like interesting revelations in terms of where people place them. So in second place, actually, I'll say who first place is because it's top two. In first place, it's Kevin De Bruyne.
It makes sense.
Yep.
But.
And Mo Salah is second.
But. Yeah, that's fair.
The reason why it's interesting is because quite a few people had Salah first. I mean, three people had him in the first. So three people are gutted. So the three people are Fuizzi. You don't want to be in company with Fuizzi. But he's a Liverpool fan.
That one, I'm with him.
Liverpool fan. Stars.
Stars had him, okay.
And Faisal. 100%. They had Mohamed Salah as the best player in the last decade of Premier League history.
I can't believe it. He finished second. 100%. I genuinely can't believe it.
To be fair,
you know, he's the only.
I'm not mad. I wouldn't be mad at Mo Salah being first. But for me personally, I think Kevin De Bruyne has been the best. That's my opinion, innit?
I had De Bruyne over Salah.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you didn't have either of them in the top two, so.
Yeah, I had Hazard and Aguero.
Aguero and Hazard first top two.
Mine was different. Mine was Kevin De Bruyne. I put Aguero, then Mo Salah.
You had Aguero second, yeah. Mm.
Yeah. I think these guys, honestly, like, again, you're picking straws, really. It's close.
What's interesting is, though, De Bruyne ended up getting first.
I don't know, Mo Salah has
De Bruyne ended up getting first,
Facts.
But could be lower than three. At eighth.
De Bruyne?
Yeah.
My heart, when I thought you said he had Mo Salah,
I said
you'd have lost it.
You know he's just here for entertainment aspect. He's entertainment aspect.
These kind of lists.
We just wanted to do clown service.
Yeah, clown service, that's it, man.
I don't think he affected the list too much, but De Bruyne still got that first spot. But if De Bruyne missed out on first because Fouzi had him at like 8th or 9th, which he did have mate, but luckily enough people had him at first, like myself, Fouad, Hasib, Renedy, Ilias, Liban, and Chunks all had De Bruyne at first, so that's what kept him there. Obviously, Fouzi had him in at 8th, and then Elias had him in 2nd lowest at 3rd. But everyone had him in their top 3. And Salah had him in, obviously, he came 2nd. Let's talk about those two and how great they've been in the Premier League, especially.
Who are we talking about first?
Let's talk about Salah first, because he came 2nd.
Yeah. I think probably obviously one of the most disrespected people.
We're talking about the last decade, but realistically, we're talking about Salah from 2017 till now.
Mm-hmm.
Because we're not talking about Salah's little stint at Chelsea.
No.
He came to the Premier League to Liverpool and took over in 2017-18 season. And that first season instantly broke the record for Premier League most goals. Hazard was in the Premier League that season, and that was one of the seasons where you didn't mention
17-18 you know
Hazard not being the best player in the league.
We got it wrong. Salah was unbelievable that season.
So that's another season that Hazard wasn't the best player in the league. It was Salah that season.
I'm
an
honest man, bro. I'll put my hands up.
Good. But yeah, that season was his first season back in the Premier League. I couldn't believe it. No one expected that.
Until Haaland.
I did, because I had him in fantasy team that whole season.
Wow.
I had him the whole season from day one.
We didn't expect that.
Yeah, from day one. So I didn't expect that, obviously. No one did, I had it from day one.
From Roma.
Yeah,
that is insane what he did. Yeah. And
bro,
like,
he put that city on his back.
That whole city, yeah. Look,
he should put a whole city on his back.
Probably reverted.
Yeah, yeah.
And he literally, like, him and Mane obviously looked after the Muslims in Liverpool, man. Changed the culture there, man.
Yeah. I would say with Mo Salah, I feel like even till now, I don't still feel like he gets the respect he deserves.
Nah, he doesn't.
He doesn't, bro. And I think if you look at the numbers, obviously
that's one person next to you who's part of that group.
The level of output, the efficiency, the effectiveness he's had in that team, bro. For me,
I don't know.
You're looking at one of the best attackers in the history of Premier League. Yeah. I'm saying up there with the Henrys and the Rooneys and the. He's up there easily.
You know, with me, Ronaldo, all of them. Okay, this is not even a joke, man. Usually I was bantering or whatever.
Yeah.
But at this,
I don't know what's about
at
to
this
say.
At this time. So, for example, obviously Salah still being there. I don't know why there's still a debate between him and Hazard.
For me,
I'm gonna be real. I think he's surpassed.
Let him go, bro. I think you killed Hazard already, bro.
But I'm saying a lot of people now do that comparison. Lee, have you seen it?
For me, I agree with you.
I think it's gone. I think Salah's won that debate.
Yeah, I think Salah's won that debate.
It's done.
In my opinion.
He's done every single Premier League legend than Hazard.
Yeah.
I think he is.
That doesn't necessarily mean I think he's got more ability.
No one does.
I think Salah's just been incredible, especially for Liverpool.
Salah cannot. Like, not take a day off kind of thing. He has to always.
I feel like
there's times where he has spells where he didn't score.
Faisal wants to itch.
Because Faisal had Salah first.
I know he wants to say something. He's itching over there in the corner.
Go on.
Come.
He had Salah first, actually. So interesting.
I find it disgraceful that no one has Salah first.
I mean, like, I just told you.
Thank you. I don't count Fouzi anyway. Thank you for you. You're telling me the person who has scored literally his first season, broke the record. His lowest scoring record in the Premier League is 19 goals. 19 goals. He's only had one season below 10 assists in the Premier League. If he had, he was two seasons away from 1 point away from winning the Premier League. He should be staying with three Premier League. If he had three Premier League, this whole argument would have been completely different. You guys are based on a trophy.
Hold on, first of all, relax.
You guys are based on trophies. If he's sitting with three trophies, this whole argument would be chilling about Salah.
Of course, trophies matter.
That's what I mean. But no. You based it on Eden Hazard just earlier.
Eden Hazard has two Premier Leagues.
You're best in either Hazard. You compared with KDB and this man.
I'm saying
Salah should be easily number one.
Easily
number one.
In the last decade of Premier League.
In the last 10 years? Yes. In the last 10 years, there's no one better than him.
What's that?
You tell me someone's better than him.
I mean, in terms of goals, he's doing that. You said about Alisson carrying Salah's the point.
I didn't say hold on. I never said Alisson carries more than Salah.
I was there, bro.
Salah has been carrying with alongside, of course, Van Dijk, hey, Trent, but he's been the main number one this season in complete different system, complete different team. He's getting you 19 goals and 20 assists. What are you telling me about Salah?
Even
how is he not number one?
Hold on.
How is he number one?
There's a man called Kevin De Bruyne that exists.
No, it's because of people only based on trophies. Like I said, if he's got three trophies, KDB's not first.
Okay, but he doesn't have three trophies, bro, because Kevin De Bruyne's team beat him to them. But hold on. What are we playing this game for, bro? At the end of the day, Kevin De Bruyne is lead. It's close. Obviously, it's close. Kevin De Bruyne and Salah have been for the last 5-6 years the best two players in the league. Yeah. No doubt about it.
Yeah.
But to just completely disregard trophies, bro, they're going neck and neck. City and Liverpool every single year for the title. Salah's been their best player. De Bruyne has been their best player. Yeah. To now just look and say, oh, they don't matter. Mm. That's ridiculous. And De Bruyne has the stats, bro. You talk about numbers that he's set, records that he's broken. He's set the standard for number 10s and creative players in the Premier League to a whole new level, bro. Yeah, he's their biggest game performer. I know you don't like hearing that, Faisal. Well. He always says he's not a great big game player.
He is.
Every single big game.
That's rubbish narrative. I think he's done now.
I hate that.
So to completely just disagree, if you have Salah first, okay, fair. I don't think he does not deserve it. Mm. But De Bruyne, 1,000% belongs in this conversation.
100%. No one's going to deny that.
This comes to your mind. It's the 1-2 in it.
It's a matter of opinions. I personally think maybe De Bruyne edges it. You can think Salah edges it. At the end of the day, it's a 6-2-3, right? Mm. It can be one or the other. They both, like I said, have been the best two players, guaranteed head and shoulders in the Premier League over the last 5-6 years.
Yeah, I just slightly think Aguero should be
more respected.
Well, I'm not mad about it.
Yeah, to be fair, you're right.
I had Salah at third.
You had Aguero,
but I'm not mad about it either. So
I think honestly, Aguero is the one that comes out of this whole list probably like the most disrespected. I think it's honestly because the last few seasons, like, he hasn't been here.
Oh, sixth actually. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, fifth.
His last great season was really 18-19. It's a while ago.
Yeah.
Really, you look at
5 years ago.
The decade, his body of work, bro. No,
unreal.
No, but yeah, Mo Salah deserves to be there anyway. Kevin De Bruyne.
You can't go wrong with Mo Salah.
The top three kind of chop and change. Like, it just depends on. Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, everyone's gonna have different arguments. But
that's our list. I mean, we got there in the end.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't see the point difference actually. Actually, I see a good point. Let's see how close they actually were in our point difference, because obviously De Bruyne got pushed down massively because Fawzi sabotaged it and put him eighth. So it might have been a bit bigger point difference, but. The point difference, oh my God. So it was out of 100 points. De Bruyne got, no, it wasn't out of 100 points. It was about 110 points. It was 11 of us, 110 points. De Bruyne got 99 out of 110. Salah got 98.
Oh, wow.
I should have just put De Bruyne one more down.
Yeah, but also Fawzi was a normal human
Fawzi
being.
Put
yeah.
De Bruyne eighth. So even put me anywhere in the top three, the point difference would be a bit bigger.
Yeah, 100%.
But it will be, it was one
you
point
can never
difference.
Go wrong with both of them anyway.
Yeah, it was one point difference. You can see how close
if I put him second, or Salah second, that would have been another point, right? Yeah. I mean, so they would be joint top.
Joint top. And then Fawzi, everyone will be angry at Fawzi because he put De Bruyne at eighth. And it's
really I'd be angry for them too. Obviously, the best players has just been Liverpool, Man City. Mm. Yeah. Been a United for now, must be.
I mean, I'm going to name. Annoying. I'm going to name. I mean, there's no Arsenal players either. So.
But just, we're not rivals with them, innit? So.
We've not been in the Champions League for almost the whole
I didn't put one Arsenal player. No way.
No one did. There's no Arsenal in our top 20. We've not been in Champions League football for the last 7 years, 8 years. That's most of the last decade.
100%.
Anyways. Let me tell you the final top 10 combined SDS list. We got there in the end. In 10th place, we had Raheem Sterling. Mm-hmm. In 9th, it was Yaya Toure. In 8th, Sadio Mane. 7th, David Silva. In 6th, and just missing out on top 5, was N'Golo Kante. Making up the top 5, in 5th place, was Sergio Aguero. Hazard in 4th.
Alhamdulillah.
Just outside the top 2, it was Harry Kane. He tipped Hazard to that third spot.
It's really interesting.
In second place, Mo Salah. And in first place was Kevin De Bruyne. That is our final SDS list. Top 10 for the last decade of the Premier League. Brought to you by Sharky, Fuad, Fuizzi, Starplay, Hasib, Rinadi, Lias, Faisal, Ilias, Liban, and Chunks. And let us know in the comment your top 10 Premier League players of the last decade.
Harry Kane finished above Hazard.
Aguero.
And Aguero.
Yep.
We winning.
There we go.
He's losing.
We'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Wait, he won something. Congratulations.